Jaime Wojtkiewicz joins us in the Newsnight kitchen today, and you work at the Blackberry Bakery located in Londonderry, and I just can't get over some of the creations you brought in. This gingerbread house is amazing.
Thank you.
It's amazing. And so you're going to be sharing your royal icing recipe, and I guess you use the royal icing on all your cookies and also to hold this gingerbread house together, right?
Yep. The royal icing is a nice, you can make it into a nice thick consistency, and it basically acts as the glue for the gingerbread house. It holds it together, and it puts on all of the little candies and everything for the gingerbread house.
And on the cookies, it also does like a really nice,
almost like a glaze.
A glaze, and it just looks so professional. So share this with us,
Jamie. So I do two different consistencies. The basic recipe is for a pound of powdered sugar, you're going to use a half a teaspoon of cream of tartar. And the cream of tartar acts as a chemical cooking agent where it will cook the egg whites acidically. And you can see in my mixing bowl here, all the little bubbles are forming. Mm-hmm. That's because of that chemical cooking process.
All right.
Once they mix together.
So right now you have cream of tartar and your powdered sugar.
And my egg whites. And around the holidays, I like to use a little bit of peppermint extract, and that gives it that nice minty flavor, sort of like a candy cane.
How many egg whites do you use in that also?
It's a tough call depending on how the consistency you want it. If you want it thicker, you're going to use much less egg whites. But when you want it really thin like this to dip the cookies, you're going to use a lot more.
Okay.
At the bakery, we just get cartons of frozen egg whites because we use a lot, and that way we're not sitting there and cracking eggs over and over.
I see. Okay, so show us how you then dip these.
Once the icing is nice and liquidy as it is here, you just take the cookie and dip it right in. I give it a little shake to kind of get some of the excess off. And then you can just lay it down right onto the rack here.
I probably would have just like painted it, but dipping it seems to work.
Dipping
a
it
lot
goes
better.
Much faster, yep.
And then when it does dry, it becomes really white.
It does, yep. And the more you mix it too, the whiter it also becomes.
Okay. All right. And then as you said before to me, you just add in more sugar if you want it to be thicker, so you could use it to keep the gingerbread house together.
Yep, I have here a container of the icing that I already made, and you can see it's much thicker. It will actually like stay right on my spatula.
Right.
And that's what you'll want when you start to do your gingerbread house. If it's too wet, the candy will start sliding right off of the roof of the house and everything. You definitely don't want that.
And another good idea, you mentioned that if you're going to be making a gingerbread house at home, make it and leave it overnight and then decorate it the next day.
Yep, build the whole house, because if you try to do everything all in one day, then it will probably be too much weight for the house and the house might break or fall apart.
Okay, Jaime, thank you so much. And as we go to break, maybe you can do a little decorating of these. Thank you so much. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.